Hi everyone, welcome to the Ginny Quick Start video. In this video, I'll introduce the overall interface and how to use each tool. First, I'll introduce the overall interface. There is a menu bar which you could find at the top. Ginny has three different modes: Avatar, Garment, and Material. You could switch between any of these modes by clicking on them. You can also find the Simulation and Upload button on the right side of the menu bar. On the left side is the library. The library is linked to Closets Connect. Here you could find provided presets, saved personal projects, as well as any items purchased from the marketplace. If you double-click on the thumbnail or drag and drop it into the 3D space, the file will download and load onto the screen. There is also a toolbar on the right. Different tools will appear in the toolbar depending on the selected mode. The screen you are looking at now is garment mode. You can see that there are 6 tools related to designing garments. To navigate around the 3D space, you can control the camera view by using a mouse. You can rotate the camera by dragging the right button. You can move the camera by holding and dragging the center scroll wheel, and zoom in and out of the camera by scrolling. Next, I'll introduce the tools of each mode. The first is Avatar mode. With the Avatar Size tool, you can edit the avatar's body size. This tool is currently supported only for the avatars provided in CLO. The supported avatars will have either FV2 or MV2 labeled on their names. You can customize their overall size, such as height and weight, and even detailed sizing options, such as the leg thickness. If you wish to revert back to the default size after making adjustments, you can return to the default size by using the reset button. You can edit the avatar's pose by using the Avatar Pose tool. Change the pose by clicking and dragging on the avatar. The black square shown means that the body part is fixed. You can click on the square to fix or further adjust the body part. And you can return to the initial state by using the reset button. Next is garment mode. In Ginny, one component that makes up the garment is called a pattern. A group of patterns connected by sewing is called a piece. You could select the piece by clicking on it. With the piece selected, you can click once more to select patterns. You can edit or delete either the selected piece or pattern. In the Edit Style Line tool, you can edit the style lines. The style lines refer to the bold lines you see when selecting a piece or pattern. You can edit them by dragging the dots and lines within the style line using your mouse. In the Draw Style Line tool, you could create style lines. You can draw by clicking on the surface of the garment. Once the style line is created, the pattern will divide into 2 sections. The Move Style Line tool allows you to edit the length of the garment. You can edit the style line by dragging it. If the garment has a lot of wrinkles after editing, you can use the Simulation tool to update and smooth out its drape. Click and drag on parts of the garment to restyle it. Using the Scale Style Line tool, you can edit the width of the garment. You can edit the style line by dragging it as well. Patterns are attached to each other through sewing. In the Edit Sewing tool, you can edit the sewing line. When selecting this tool, the pattern will arrange in this exploded view for editing. You can see that the lines appear in many colors. Those are sewing lines. A sewing line indicates which part of one pattern attaches to another. You can edit it by dragging both ends of the sewing line or dragging the whole line. You can also delete the sewing line by clicking on it and pressing Delete. In the Create Sewing tool, you can add a sewing line to attach 2 patterns. Patterns will appear exploded while using this tool. Click to select the start and end points to add sewing arrangements to both patterns. By observing the applied sewing, you could see in advance how it will be sewn. Once you use the Simulation tool, patterns will sew together. Lastly is Material mode. In this mode, you can add details such as coloring your clothes or attaching buttons. The item list here is where the items currently used in the project are indicated. You can also prepare the items needed in advance using this item list. You can either drag and drop it from the library, or upload a file from your computer through the plus button. To use these items, drag and drop them onto the clothing. In the color tool, you could change the color of an item. Select an item and adjust the value within the property window to edit. Not only can you color the item, but also the material as well. It's not necessary to drag and drop items every time. Using the Assign tool, you can assign the selected item from the item list only with a mouse click. Also, if you switch the Assign method to Replace All in the Property window, you could change the same type of material at once. In the Select tool, you can edit the location of an item attached to the garment surface. When you select, you will see a gizmo appear, which allows you to edit the size and rotation of the item. So now that we've covered the interface of the new application, we hope that you won't have any trouble creating designs with Jinny. Thank you for watching our video, and please share any feedback in the comments.